An attorney for Staff Sergeant Robert Bales says that describes the soldier from Norwood accused of killing 16 Afghan civilians. But those closest to Bales have fonder memories. And now a man who lived next to him growing up talks with us about the Bobby he knew.
Robert Durham remembers his last conversation with Sergeant Robert Bales, who called him from Afghanistan.
I said, "I love you, Bobby, you know. Take care of yourself."
That was in December, shortly after Bales was redeployed to the region for a fourth time.
A real caring, real understanding individual, even from a real young age.
Durham has known Bales all his life. They lived next door to each other in Norwood. He still calls him Bobby.
Bobby and my son were best friends.
An uncommonly kind friend, because Durham's son, Wade, 2 years older than Bales, is severely disabled.
Bobby was just a very understanding, very accepting kid. He didn't at one time point out a kid's disability. It was what they could do.
Bobby took Wade swimming, to school parties, to the zoo. Bobby made sure Wade was never left out, no matter what anyone thought.
And with Bobby around, there was never a question. All of Bobby's friends accepted Wade because Bobby accepted him.
At Norwood High, Bales was a football captain. Yearbook photos show him typing and also his playful side. After attending two colleges and working in finance, a fateful day, 9/11, 2001.
9/11 really affected Bobby.
Within 2 months, he joined the Army.
He was like a lot of young men and women who decided that not on our watch. You don't do this to our country.
When they talked about the war, Durham says Bales empathized with civilians.
People are people to him. People are people. I've never heard him say that he hated anyone.
Like most, Durham was horrified to hear about an American soldier who allegedly gunned down 16 Afghan villagers door to door.
They're saying Bobby did that, and I couldn't believe it. I still can't believe it. I can't believe it. The Bobby that I knew is not the Bobby that could have done that.
Durham suspects his friend may have snapped, and he's worried.
I don't think he can live with it. He'll never be the same. And that he's such a great person. That crushes me. I don't know. I think everyone has the same question because everyone knew the same Bobby. What happened?
Questions with few answers.
I don't know what happened to my friend Bob Bales. I hope somebody figures it out.
And gets him help.